Hello again, everyone. We are Gaming by Gaslight. Welcome back to our RimWorld playthrough in Zombieland. When we last left off, we were in the dead of winter. And there's actually something I want to quickly experiment with here. Be here. Build stone over this. The answer is no. Alright. I need to figure out. Like, I know. I was experimenting with this a bit off camera. No, so I'd ideally know what I was doing on camera, but then I didn't really get all the way through with my own tutorial-y stuff. And it seems that I can't actually build structures over, like, walls that is over the water here. So, yeah. We're gonna have to work on that, basically. That sounded really close. Alright. That's a lot of grenades. HE, what does that mean? High explosive, huh? Used by a grenade launcher of some sort. Alright, Dick, you know what to do. Oh, yeah, we gotta... You know what? No, I'm not gonna risk Ace. Dick, didn't I... Oh, wrong person. So that does bring to my attention the fact that I apparently have not gotten around to swapping Bowman's schedule out. Which is odd. You'd figure I would have done that. Alright, so let's keep an eyeball on Dick here. Make sure that he ideally doesn't get, you know, completely murdered by zombies out there. Alright, so yeah, let's get all these... All these rounds in here. I mean, we don't even have a gun that can fire them, but you know, maybe someone with an arsenal will show up and they'll be able to take care of that for us. I don't know. Also, apparently Ace found some charge cartridges for us. Good. More charge cartridges, the better. Because we kind of need those, actually, as it turns out. There's a lot of rounds here. There is surely little chance. You know, go ahead and kill that, please. All right, go have a bowel movement. And right, our wild boar is, yeah, I'm just gonna mark it for slaughter because I just can't stand it. Also, you know what I hate? There's a debuff now for slaughtering animals, isn't there? Which I don't like, mostly because like, if it was a dog, yeah, I understand that, but for your livestock. But then again, I guess the game doesn't really have a simple and clean... Actually, is there actually a mode bonus? Am I complaining about, oh. I might be complaining about nothing, actually. That's old Gaslight for you. Anyway, Psychic Soup is ending. Yeah, we have a ridiculous amount of meat. Also, let's scroll over. Yeah. There's a lot of dead stuff that's frozen here. At some point, we will haul all this back in. I mean, there is a lot of... Okay, you're gonna go out of your way to butcher that? I mean, cool. Just don't get eaten. You know what? I'm gonna make a risky move here, and I'm gonna let... Actually, maybe I'm gonna leave this forbidden just so that, you know, there's a little bit of food for the, yeah, for these things to eat. I mean, there's also the brachiosaur over there, but, yeah. I want to see if Ace will haul some stuff in for us, though my gut tells me that's a bad idea, and it's gonna result in our dog getting murdered, and also our dog is vomiting. Good job. Alright, Dick, it's daytime. I know I have you working like all night and then all day again, but let's clean up in here. Because the less dirty it is, the more likely less likely, rather, it is that we'll end up, developing horrible, horrible food poisoning issues. And food poisoning is bad, as you might imagine. Also, I really need to remember, get the bloody mod that lets you, like, grab a bunch of stuff all at once and then bulk prepare it. I mean, also, it would really increase our efficiency if we actually, like, got this kitchen up and running. So many things we need to do, we'll find time eventually. I should probably clean up all this as well. How are we doing anyway? It's still dirty though, because there's dirt right there. How did that dirt even get in here? Who is tracking in all this dirt? It's still dirty. I just can't win. There's no winning. Even with this welcome mat out there, we're still apparently tracking in like all kinds of dirt. Ridiculous. We need like a Roomba just to be like 24/7 taking care of this garbage. Anyway, also speaking of flooring, let's see here. I mean, maybe if I, oh, there's slate out there. Maybe if we, you know, get like a little patio thing going out here, maybe that'll help us a little bit. All right, you are butchering in holy balls. There goes that, I guess. All right, I'm gonna suspend butchering for now. No more butchering. We'll leave the dead animals to, you know, to rot out there. I mean, we could haul them in. That's good. Are you going to bed as well? You should be soon. We gotta refuel that, this thing. Gotta get a proper bed for our dog, too. Let's look at that now, shall we? Let's see here. Animal sleeping. Animal bed. Brachiosauricide. Only the best for our dog. What is this? You're scared of zombies. Fine, I'll send you away. Only the best for our dog. There we go. I mean, we'll get around to building that at some point. God, we need a proper storage room. Which also reminds me again that it was probably a bit of a mistake to build into... Was that snapping sound me? I thought I heard something like sound like snapping a twig. Maybe I was spitting into the microphone. Sorry about that if so. Also, I'm going to adjust the microphone a little bit. Bring it a little closer to my mouth. Just because it occurred to me it's been kind of a distance away and that's less good. Much less good. Okay. I mean, we're trying. We're trying. You're gonna spend like all day on this. Oh God, we're bringing in more dirt. Where's the dirt coming from? Is it coming from out here? Could be coming from out here actually. Oh no, there's, if there's dirt here. I mean, I note there is dirt on the mat. Maybe I should reinstall the mat inside? Let's try reinstalling it inside. I mean, we also have this second mat, which we could then go ahead and install out here. Actually, before you do anything else, could you, clean all this blood and guts that's lying around out here. And also this dirt here, too. And this dirt right here in the doorway. There we go. Alright, good. Or at least good enough. It'll have to do. Oh, look at all that hideous, disgusting dirt. There's just too much dirt. I don't like it. What is the quality set for this? Just make sure it's at least good. That's all I ask for. I mean, I guess we'll want to do the same thing for Dick himself. And a Brachiosaurus has self-tamed. Okay, I mean, sure, why not? I mean, Brachiosaurs eat trees, right? I mean, they're like Frumbos, they'll just eat the tree right up. Probably, maybe. I mean, if he can eat the tree, and a chunk of a spacecraft has landed nearby, so that's cool, I guess. Oh my god, that's a lot of chunks. Now, does spacecraft drop steel as well as components, or is it just components? I forget exactly. Or is it plasteel that they drop? Ooh, look at that! Normal quality bed, right there. Sexy. I like that. Still trying to build a good quality bed. You know what? Work on that bed. Alrighty then. So, just kind of fast-forwarding a little. What is this? Is that a bomb? It's an explosive sack. Cool. Anyway, yeah, so, yeah. Just kind of fast-forwarded a little since there wasn't much going on, just your day-to-day menial hauling of stuff. Are you okay? I mean, I guess that's a clever tactic. But I said they were going to prepare for a bit. It seems like they are directly maneuvering into killing me. Which is less good, to be honest with you. Also, let's send Dick. Dick. Right, it's right click. Inch it. Kinda weird clipping going on over there. Anyway, oh, you know what? Actually, now that I think about it, might as well send Bowman down as well once you're done. Alright. Yeah. Oh god, you're like already here. Well, you've been suppressed. Yeah, you damn well better run. Anyway, you know, aside from that, Dick, you can go there. Bowman, you can go hide over here. Okay, don't fire, Will, please. Yeah, y'all better run, y'alls. Oh, Dick, it's your time to shine. Damn right no one's gonna fire at your funeral. Agent, what's your health? You've got a bad back. How old are you? You're 45 years old and you already got a bad back. Oh, jeez. I mean, I'm not gonna save you. Just want that to be clear. I'm gonna go strip your clothes off. Because why the heck not? You know, before you die. That way we can have your clothes. I mean, I suppose I should haul you back somewhere first and then take your clothes off, but you know. Also, don't fire, Will. Wait until these dicks attack. Or are you guys ready to attack, are you? I mean, they don't even have range on me. Oh yeah, look at that, we've got him. Oh, and you're out of ammo. Oh god, you're all out of ammo, huh? Alright, well you should go home, I guess. Dick, maybe you should go equip some of those rounds that Ace found for us. I mean, are you at least bleeding to death a little bit? No, you didn't even get hit. Didn't even get hit. Wonderful. Well, they tried, and they failed miserably. But, you know. It's all good. Yeah. Alright, let's go back. Oh. It's like Woodard's coming back for round two here, huh? Oh, man, that wooden thing is pretty good. Actually, wait, why am I even bothering? How good are you at... Yeah, you have like no melee skill compared to Dick. Dick is going to mess you up, son. If only I had given him like a spear or something. Dick? You know, you could... Oh, right, you can't actually cross deep. Okay, you know what? Never mind. Just shoot him, Dick. There we go. Much easier. Alright, are you worth anything? Can't do intellectual or fire. Oh, you're one of those people. You're a pyro. Yeah, go ahead and strip off Woodard's clothes. I mean, granted, Pyros aren't that terrible, but I'm just not gonna risk it, okay? Not happening. I will say, though, I'm actually rather impressed that these guys haven't given up yet. Alright, yeah, you reload and then... Whoop. Oh, there's still three of them left. The fact they're kind of like too stupid to... And you're gonna run. Of course you're gonna run. But I'm not gonna let you run. Actually, you know what? Melee attack Fidosa to death. Yeah, I mean, you're a five. Just a measly little five. You're not gonna challenge me. Probably, maybe. I mean, you might. And you know what? I'm gonna unrestrict, oh, Ace is unrestricted. Maybe he'll haul some of the, yeah, just beat Fidosia to death. And by beat to death, I mean, you know, preferably knock her out. I mean, she's good at construction. Eh, but she's dead. You know, I even have that whole mod that supposedly lets you... Oh, right, right. No. Oh, is there just no room left in the, Oh, there we go. All that wooden shiv. Alright. So no one made it out of that alive, except for us. Which is good, because, frankly, they sucked. They sucked at life. Kinda wish, the more useful people had survived, though. Like, let's see what we could have had. I mean, someone who's really good at punching, but is kinda slow. A kind brawler, who's really artistic. I mean, that would have been pretty cool. You're dead. We weren't going to take you anyway because of your bad back. But then again, I could have just ripped out your spine and given you a fresh one. So I suppose maybe... Yeah. I mean, nervous. A little bit less good there. But, yeah, you would have been pretty useful. Is Ace doing more work at this hour? God, what a good dog, huh? You wouldn't work when these two lazy bums have already gone to sleep. Anyway, yeah. I mean, we were lucky that Ace apparently managed to find some rounds lying somewhere. You know, there was probably like a merchant traveler or something who died. They happened to have charge rounds, but then again, I don't remember seeing... Anyway, I don't know where the charge rounds came from. I just know that Ace found them somewhere. It'd actually be kind of a cool feature if your, like, animals of hauling could just randomly dig stuff up. But it must have been on the map somewhere. There we are. Classic sleeping style there. It actually seems weird to me. Like, you ever seen, like, older timey things where it's like, there's like a married couple, but they each sleep in like a different bed? I mean, to be honest, like, it's probably not just like a sign of an older, outdated, prudish timeline. I mean, it's probably partially that. But more likely it's, you know, like back in the days before, you know, fancy modern beds where you can like have one side, like one, you know, thing and the other side another. You know, maybe there was like, you know, one person in the couple or one member of the couple, whatever. One of the pair, one of the spouses. You know, liked a softer bed and one liked a harder bed or something, or maybe just, you know, one was always stealing the sheets. So they're like, it's more comfortable to have two separate beds or something. I don't know. All I'm saying is that it was probably not just about a prudish time with sex is evil. Woo! It's actually kind of sad there's still people who think that. I mean, granted, you know, like, to phrase that even more specifically, I'm not necessarily saying that people who, like, you know, hold sex to be like something that, you know, you're supposed to save until marriage or whatever. You know, that's perfectly valid as long as, you know, you're not basically forcing other people to follow that point of view, I guess, is what I'm getting at here. Yeah. I mean, in general, most ideologies aren't bad as long as you're not shoving them down other people's throats. Which, you know, it's a problem in the world that, you know, we could deal. Do you have a composite vest? You do, good. Anyway, we could deal with less ideology shoving, I guess. But then again, maybe I'm shoving my ideology of acceptance down over people's throats. I don't know. It seems to be, I don't know, acceptance and tolerance for other people who are different than you seems to be something I consider pretty important anyway. I mean, I guess mostly just because I'd want people to accept me for who I am, and I try to accept people for who they are. It's hard sometimes, but, you know, I mean, generally it feels good to not be a dick to other people, so that's my philosophy. Don't be a dick. Unless your name is Dick, in which case, then I guess you are a dick. But not that kind of dick. Or the other kind. Or possibly the other kind? Is there even an other kind? Maybe. Anyway, enough about dicks. Getting back to our zombies. There's 63 zombies out here. We've got a bunch of stuff. We've got a cool hat lying around. I see Dick has gone full cowboy here. Probably mine this out eventually. I kind of don't like the fact that, like, on account of the limited ammo, I sort of feel like I have to babysit people if I send them out. But then again, I guess if it makes me actually pay attention to what they're doing in their lives, that's probably not a bad thing. Meanwhile, I didn't accidentally restrict Ace, did I? No. No, I did not. Okay, good. What is this? You're scared of zombies. Sure, why not? You can have some safety. I mean, they're probably gonna end up hating me. Just two of them, but as long as they hang out in the safe zone, then we should be reasonably okay. Reasonably. I mean, this place is still really bad. I mean, we have, like, these terrible guest beds that are not actually beds. It's just, like, designated spots on the floor with maybe a pillow, if you want to be generous and imagine there's, like, a pillow here. But, I mean, we're living in a cave. We're working on it. We gotta get rid of this whole barracks thing eventually as well. To be honest, maybe I should just build, like, a little guest hut right here. We'll consider it. Or maybe over here, actually. No, that's too out of the way. What is Ace doing? He's gonna go kill that zombie like a boss. What a boss. What a good dog. Anyway, who is our best recruity, warden-y, negotiate-y person? That is Dick. Dick is the best. Dick is the best at what he does. Let's try engaging with them a little bit. Try to improve relations. A little bit. Okay, good. We did a bit of charming. That's good. So at least they'll hate us slightly less. We'll get rid of some of these shivs. Now, is a shiv better than a knife? I think, well, Gladius is probably better than either. So, yeah. Getting, like, basically nothing, but not terrible. Let's see. I suppose. Oh, I've got a. Well, no, I knew we had that. We have frag grenades lying around? That's news to me, but, you know, that's good. Let's see here. A shoddy hat. Tactical vest. I mean, I'll sell it. They don't really want anything else from us. Don't really need much from them either. I'll keep some of these extra clothes around here because we're not really doing anything else. Herbal medicine, they've only got one of it. Could buy some pemmican, but it's not like we really need the food. Could sell the sand. But no, you know what? We'll keep the sand because we might want to build some sandbags later. Alright, I mean, that's good enough. Alright, so there we go. Anyway, hopefully they have a good time and they like our terrible, terrible colony. Let's clean some dirt. I can't help but feel like these carpets are not actually doing anything to keep the dirt out. The carpets have failed. They had one job, carpet. One job. They failed miserably at keeping the dirt out. Well, it's only slightly dirty now. Maybe it's because the dirt keeps piling up in here. In between these two doormats. Could be. Yeah, I mean, all the dirt out here. Yeah, look, they brought some more dirt in. Stupid rug, you're supposed to keep the dirt out. But apparently, apparently they're not. Unless I'm supposed to put this, like, directly in the door frame. Does that even make sense? Can I do it? Oh. Maybe that's how it's supposed to go. I mean, I'll try it. It can't hurt. I mean, then we'll have, like, mismatched rugs, but... You know what? I like it. It's good enough. Oh, wait. Does that even make sense? Let's look at the furniture rugs here. Rugs. Nope. Selenius. There we are. Yeah, doormat. Does it actually say where to put it? Doormat to clean your feet. I mean, like, I can put it in the doorway, apparently. Yeah, maybe that's where it's supposed to go. Oh, well. I mean, whatever it's supposed to do, it's, you know, good enough. How are you feeling, by the way? Guest. Let's see. Does not like enough of your colonists. Oh. Okay. Prioritize engaging again. Alright. Enough. Okay, now we could theoretically recruit people. We've got some goodwill. I think. No shopping. No shopping. That's good. We'll set up a shopping area eventually, maybe. Dick is such a charmer. Here, you can even engage with Hyena here. I mean, we want them to like us. Okay, yeah, the hospitality is... It's there. Alright. But... Yeah, well, I guess they're sort of okay with it. But then again, are they gonna stick around forever the longer I let them stay here? Oh god, I accidentally offended her. Well, that's not good. Well, we're doing the best we can, and that's the important thing. Though the best we can is apparently not very good, so. There is that to consider. Also, this episode has kind of meandered on probably long enough, even with me trying to cut some of the drudgery out. So let's wrap things up here. So until the next time, as always, thank you all for watching. I hope you all enjoyed. Don't forget to hit that like button or maybe leave me a comment down below. Let me know what you're thinking. And I will see all you in the next video.